So I think a sense of entrepreneurialism is probably something that was embedded in my degree, which I was always interested in managing others, in having my own business. My business degree really fostered that as well. And then once I went into law, I always had this sense that I'd like to do law a bit differently and shake things up a little bit. And I ultimately did open my own practice after I had the industry experience that I needed to be able to do so. So I think that that sense of entrepreneurialism is something that drove me to the point where I am today.
When I think about what a group of graduate influence looks like, the kinds of things that come to mind and what I consider important in influence, firstly, interestingly, is being innovative. I think of being a graduate of influence and coming to a university like Griffith is you can quite rightly feel confident that you have the knowledge and you have the skills to be innovative, because managers are seeking that. We're seeking fresh ideas from graduates to look towards changing the workplace and making it a better place for everyone to work.
Look, for me, innovative, creative, and entrepreneurial is that's a real passion of mine. When you look at Indigenous issues, and there's about 600,000 Indigenous people across the country, about 70,000 of those are in the most disadvantaged group. So for the most part, the majority are fine. But when you travel to those areas where there are the most disadvantaged, often there are a number of issues. And for me, it actually comes back to an economic issue. There are social issues, housing, education, all those things. So I go into a community like Palm Island, for example, 2,500 people with no economy. And I'm working on this case and I'm thinking, okay, well, how can we start building an economy here on this island? Like, how can we start, building an economy to support 2,500 people, but then producing something that we can export to do even more?